Moyen, Kevin Wester here with Luxembourg Dual Citizenship Consultation Services. I get phone calls and emails just about every day from people inquiring, is it still possible to get Luxembourg dual citizenship? And yes, absolutely, it is. Now, the first track that started in 2008, the procedure was called Article 89. Now that procedure, the original one, is closed to new applicants. That closed December 31st, 2018. But ever since 2017, Luxembourg allows for two other procedures for people to attain dual citizenship. One of the procedures is called Article 7. It's a one-stage process. And then there's Article 23, a two-stage process. People find these very confusing, so let me see if I can help you out and decipher it. What is Article 7? Article 7 says that if you come from an all-male Luxembourg lineage, that you can apply through the one-stage process. It's really kind of the simplest way to attain dual citizenship. The all-male Luxembourg lineage. Let's take me, for instance. I come from an all-male lineage. My great-great-grandpa was Melchior Wester from Bertrange, Luxembourg. My great-grandpa was Henry Wester. Grandpa was Al Wester. Dad was Bert Wester. And then there's me. So I come from an all-male lineage. I'd have to go through the one-stage process. It's rather straightforward. But what about if you have one woman in the lineage, sort of at the later part of the lineage? I'll make this up. So let's make believe there's an immigrant, Franz Gangler, and let's say he was from Kolpak, Luxembourg. Franz Gangler's son was Raymond Gangler, and then the son was Frederick Gangler. Then Frederick had a daughter, and the daughter's name is Sarah Gangler. Well, Sarah Gangler would qualify through Article 7, because Sarah, even though she's a woman, she comes from an all-male lineage. But what about Sarah's children or grandchildren? That's where it gets a little confusing. Well, Luxembourg's law said as of January 1st, 1969, that a woman had the ability to pass on nationality or citizenship. So Sarah could definitely get citizenship. She comes from an all-male Luxembourg lineage. If she has children born after January 1st, 1969, they and their children, whether they're male or female, would qualify for Article 7 because nationality could be passed on to her through her to her children. If Sarah has children born before January 1st, 1969, unfortunately, they don't qualify for Article 7. They would qualify for Article 23, that two-stage process. Let's talk about Article 23, and it's the most confusing of them all. Article 23 says this: if a person has a parent or grandparent who is or was a Luxembourg citizen, then they have a right to reclaim Luxembourg citizenship through that parent or grandparent. But it also says if they have a parent or grandparent who could have been a Luxembourg citizen or would have had the right to apply, even if that parent or grandparent is deceased at this point, you would have the right to reclaim it through them. Again, if you have a parent or grandparent who would have been entitled to Luxembourg nationality, even if they're deceased, you would have a right to apply for them. It's a two-stage process. In stage one, we have to get a nationality or citizenship certificate for your parent or grandparent. And then in stage two, you have to go to Luxembourg to formally apply with a bunch of your application documents. I know this stuff gets really kind of confusing, especially Article 23. Many more people still qualify for Luxembourg dual citizenship than what I think people think. If you'd like help from me to unpack whether you qualify or not through Article 7 or Article 23, please feel free to contact me. My email is kevin@luxdualcitizenship.com or my phone number in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, 262-355-5758. I'd be happy to help you work through this and determine whether or not you qualify. Thank you. Eddie.